As I look at our offense, I really feel like we have two very outstanding leaders, you know, out there right now, and both of them are two of our three captains are on offense this year. Actually, the first time that's happened, you know, here where we've had two offensive captains. First is Jake Benson. You know, Jake is a returning starter for us on the offensive line. Jake actually, he's going into his junior year now. Last year started every game as a sophomore. His freshman year, he ended up starting the last, you know, three or four games of the year in the national playoffs as a freshman. So Jake's got a lot of experience. And, you know, just at the end of our spring practices, our team voted for captains, and Jake was one of the overwhelming, you know, favorites in terms of number of votes received. And, you know, really he's done an outstanding job here. The thing about Jake Benson is he's one of the hardest working guys we have, if not the hardest working guy we have on the team. You know, this kid's just not going to be outworked. So he sets a tremendous example, you know, for other players to follow, particularly younger players. You know, through a tremendous work ethic, he has really become a much more effective communicator. You know, he and I talked, you know, some time ago about maybe that being one of his weaknesses, and Jake actively improved his communication skills and the way he relates to his teammates. And I really feel like that's helped him a lot. And the other thing is, you know, Jake has really demonstrated a willingness and eagerness, really, to help his fellow teammates. He really cares about helping those guys and helping guys improve and get better. So I'm very optimistic about the leadership that we've gotten out of him, and I feel like we're going to continue to get out of him. And the other guy, of course, would be Josan Holmes. He's our other offensive captain this year. And again, you talk about a guy with experience. You know, Josan is he's been starting every game here since his freshman year, and you know, he's already broken a host of records and everything else. He probably has more game experience than anyone else on this team. So, you know, and again, coming at the end of spring ball is our team voted for captains. Again, he's an overwhelming favorite. You know, very, very well-liked and well-respected young man by his teammates. Again, you know, Josan has a very strong work ethic, you know, particularly on the field. When he sets foot on that field between those white stripes, he only has one speed, and that's full go, you know, all the time. And, you know, really a singleness of purpose, you know, when he gets on that field, that he wants to do everything he can to help our team be as successful as possible. A very unselfish player. We've asked him to play a whole host of different roles on the field in terms of being a running back and being a return specialist and doubling as a receiver. And you know, he'll do whatever we ask of him. And the thing that Josan has really, I think, excelled at, you know, probably over the last 8-10 months, going into about the midway point of last year, is, you know, his ability to communicate with the team in a positive fashion. And as I said, very well respected, I think, because of that. And when Josan speaks, it seems to me that everyone listens. You know, and so in terms of leadership, those are really the two main guys that I think we're looking towards, with the most experience, and obviously they've been recognized as captains by their teammates, so they've got some credibility there to become leaders, and really a responsibility to improve their leadership skills. So those are the two that I would say. Well, as you know, we've had a quarterback battle, you know, going on since the start of last season. And, you know, it was no different this spring. I mean, we started this spring with, some very talented quarterbacks. Both T.J. Luddy and Adam Galzinski were 1-2, neck and neck the whole way. And then there's some other guys there that were battling for that position. And, you know, Griffin Eldridge and Mark McHugh. And so, you know, we've got some talent there. There's been a lot of competition, a lot of healthy competition. But this spring, TJ edged out Adam, you know, to earn the starting job going into the spring game, both the inter-squad game, the red and white, and then into Canada. And so he won the job. But I'll tell you, it was a battle. And those guys were really neck and neck. I mean, one day I would look at the film TJ's performance was better than Adam, and then, maybe I think I know what the answer is, and the next day Adam would come out and show up TJ. So I think it's a healthy competition. Those guys are both competitors. They're both getting better every day and improving, on a weekly basis, on a daily basis even. Both gym rats and both office rats, in the office watching film and trying to learn and improve and get better. But TJ won the job this spring, going in the spring game. His performance in the spring game I thought was very good. And, he'll be the number one guy as we come into camp. Now, that being said, nobody's job is ever secure. Everyone has to earn their spot every day. And that's just the way we run the program, that, really there are no returning starters, so to speak. It's everyone's got to compete. And that's all we promise anyone, is the opportunity to compete, and what you do with that opportunity is up to you. So you ask me this, who's going to be the starting quarterback against Ursinus? I'm going to tell you, the guy that earns the job, and the guy that comes into camp in the best shape and the best shape physically, mentally, strength-wise, conditioning-wise, everything else, and then on the field he performs, and really, I've always looked at it like this. My starting quarterback is the guy that when he's on the field, the offense moves the ball and scores points. Whether you're running or passing or having to throw screens to do it, everyone seems to play better when he's on the field. That's who the starting quarterback is. And I said right now that's TJ Luddy, but I'm expecting a challenge, certainly from Adam as both those guys continue to push and move forward, and probably a challenge from some of the other guys too. Very talented group at that position. Well, we've already talked about Josan Holmes as a leader. So let me come at this more as a player. You're asking, how would I like to see him finish out his career? I guess in one umbrella statement, I'll say this. I'd like to see Josan Holmes do everything he possibly can do to help this team win a championship. And I've got no doubt that he's going to do that. Yes, he's set a lot of records, single season rushing and touchdown records, and I think he's got some career records already. But I think he would agree with you that those records pale in comparison to winning a championship as a team. And I've got no doubt that Josan's going to do that. He's going to do everything in his power to help us win. I guess some things I would like to see him do is become more of a durable player or a more durable player. He's had some nagging injuries over the years that maybe limited some of his reps. And I would like to see him become much more durable so that we can get him the ball more, so that we can rely on him on a more consistent basis. No, he's very consistent. It has been very consistent. But if you've got to, come out for a series because a guy's a little bit banged up, well, there's a series of reps that we can't get him the ball. So, but we're going to ask him to do a lot. And we're going to ask him to carry a lot of the load in the backfield in terms of, running the football. We're going to ask him to double as a wide receiver, as I mentioned before. And so he's got to understand the pass game thoroughly. And all the adjustments and the coverage adjustments and everything else. And we're going to ask him to continue to be involved in special teams and be a primary return man. One of Josan's, greatest gifts physically is his ability to make people miss. And so you want a guy like that, you want to get the ball in his hands as many times as you can and let him do what God gave him the talent to do. But for us to reach our full potential, I believe that he's got to have tremendous senior year, which that's what I'm expecting of him. Well, in terms of defining the offense, I mean, really nothing changes for us. We're going to focus on the same three things that we have always focused on in this offense, and there's really three objectives every game day for us. Number one, we want to run the ball well. Secondly, we want to throw the ball accurately. And thirdly, we want to excel at beating the blitz. And we feel like if we can do those three things, if at the end of the day, we can answer yes to those three things when posed as questions, we feel like, you know, we've probably had a pretty good day offensively. You know, that just doesn't mean we have to run for 500 yards a game. Run the ball well. That means run the ball when you want to run the ball and run it well. You know, one of the things that we measure is we're looking to get 4 yards a carry if we can do that. Whether that meant that we ran the ball 20 times or we ran the ball 40 times, if we've averaged 4 yards a carry, we believe that, you know, we have forced the defense to stop the run. Throw the ball accurately. You know, again, we rely on a very high percentage pass game. We do take a lot of shots down the field for big plays, certainly, and we're going to continue to do that. But we want to be accurate with our passes. You know, I tell the quarterbacks all the time that great decisions result in big plays. And, you know, that's extremely true if you're looking for an accurate passing game. Let's take what the defense has given us. Let's throw the ball with proper fundamentals and proper ball placement. Let's give the wide receiver a chance to do something with the ball after the catch. From a receiving standpoint, we've got to communicate coverage and adjust the coverages on the run, and we've got to make the catch. And up front, you know, we've got to protect, you know, certainly to let the quarterback do his job. And then the third thing, I think we've got to excel at beating the blitz, because when you become an effective offense and when you're really threatening the opponent, both through the air and on the ground, in many cases they have no choice but to pressure you. And a lot of teams on our schedule their personality is to pressure you anyway. I mean, they're going to blitz more times than not. So we've always felt like we've got to excel at beating the blitz, whether that's in the run game or the pass game, whether that means that we need to check to a play at the line of scrimmage to beat the blitz, or we've got to, you know, have play calls that are designed, you know, to beat that blitz, or you know, what have you. But we got to be able to pick that blitz up and beat it in the pass game and beat it in the run game. You know, and then obviously our screen game is somewhat designed, you know, to beat that blitz. But those are the three things that we're looking to do. You know, the other thing that I'll say, you know, is really a team goal, but it extends to the offense, you know, and every unit, offense, defense, and special teams. And I think it's very critical for our success is, you know, we want to be the most physical and aggressive team on the field. So I say we want to be the most physical and aggressive offense on the field. You know, we want to be the best prepared team on the field, best prepared offense on the field. And, we want to be the most fundamentally sound team on the field. So we're trying to be fundamentally sound offensively as well. So everything that we do is kind of designed around those objectives. And, you ask what's our offense going to be known for? Hopefully those are the things that we're known for. How we will measure up offensively in the MAC conference, you know, once again, I mean, you've heard me say this many times, it's a very, very competitive league, and it's very strong defenses, very strong offenses in this league. And there's going to probably be some teams that are going to throw for more yards than us. There's probably going to be some teams that are going to run for more yards than us. Really, what we'd like to do is be successful, probably be the most successful team in terms of running a balanced offense. You know, and again, run the ball well, throw the ball accurately, excel at beating the blitz. And that might not put us at the top of every category, but if it can put us at or near the top in terms of scoring, in terms of total offense, when you add it all together, I think we're going to be right there, able to compete with everybody. But I think the key is to be balanced, and that's our objective all the time. That's what we're looking to do. And there's going to be some games where we're going to have to throw the ball around. And there's going to be some games where the game plan is going to call for us to grind it out more, you know, on the ground. But we're going to take what the defense gives us, in most cases, and at other times in a game, and every game at other times, we're going to do what we want to do. We're not going to be dictated to. And if we want to run, we're going to run. If we want to throw, we're going to throw. It doesn't matter what coverage they're in or what front they're in. We're going to do what we want to do. But the most important thing to me is let's be balanced. You know, over the course of a season, let's be balanced. Percentages are going to be very different from game to game, but let's be balanced and let's do the things we want to do, and let's do them well. Let's not be great. Let's not be average at everything. Let's try to be great at a few things, and really that's our focus.